Brooks Blanger here with B&B Drainage Solutions, and today I'm finishing up a job that I think will help demonstrate and hopefully help drive home the point that I always try to make when it comes to selecting and choosing the correct drainage pipe for your drainage system. As drainage contractors, whenever we go into a job, there's always going to be constraints that we face that is going to put a challenge on the final design and sometimes the installation of that drainage system. These constraints come in the form of budget constraints, site condition constraints, and in some instances, few, rare, the client may make a special request that can add some constraints and headaches to the installation process. And although this site had three of those particular strengths come into play, the one that I want to focus on the most are site condition constraints. Because ultimately, it is site condition constraints that are going to determine not only a system's capabilities, but also its limitations. And the biggest constraint that any drainage contractor faces is going to be site conditions, and that is going to pertain to slope. Had site condition constraints and the limited slope on this particular site been taken into consideration whenever the previous system was installed, it would have been clear that corrugated pipe wasn't the best choice for the drainage system on this particular job site. So let's go back here, take a quick look, and I'll go over it a little bit closer in more detail. This is the area that had the drainage issues actually beneath the porch here. You had water collecting and standing in that area, and it was getting up against the foundation wall, creating water entry into the crawl space, which runs from this corner here and then ends in this general area over here. So you had water entry, and then you had also that water getting up against the foundation wall, creating and contributing to some very damp conditions in the crawl space, which led to some mold growth on the joist beams. So what was contributing to the water getting beneath the porch is you have this pool slab here, which all sheds this way towards that staircase right there. Water goes underneath it. The pool company did install a French drain. However, they did that completely wrong. But I don't want to focus on that for this particular video. And then also you had some gutter downspout drain lines, which had in some areas become partially clogged and in others pretty much completely clogged, which was causing those lines to back up and leak water out of the connection points. And that's what you saw me doing at the beginning of the video, is removing that drain line from this downspout right here. And that's what I want to focus on, is this downspout to this downspout in that area right there for this video. So the client added another constraint to this particular job, and that is he wanted his gutter downspout drain lines installed without having to completely remove the porch. In order to do that, you have two options. One is to lay your pipe on grade until you get over here, then go below grade. Or the other option is you're gonna hang it from the beams of the porch and install it in similar fashion as you would an indoor plumbing job. And I'll be putting up pictures as I go through the video showing you what I did. But we also have another constraint, and that is some site conditions constraints. Because from this downspout to this downspout is 35 feet. And the fall on that area was about 3.5 inches, which leaves you slightly shy of the required 1% fall for every 10 feet or 1.25 inches of fall for every 10 feet. So that right there should have been an indication not to use corrugated pipe for your downspout drain lines, because let's look at the 1% slope rule and understand where that's coming from. It's typically used in the plumbing industry, especially those in the installing sewer lines, and they want that 1% slope so that they can get good water movement, but also more importantly that they're able to push debris through their drain lines. Whenever installing corrugated pipe to achieve that same flow rate, which allows you to push debris, you have to increase your slope from 1% to 2%. When PVC pipe and corrugated pipe are set and laid at the same slope, PVC pipe, smoothbore PVC pipe, has a greater flow rate than that of corrugated pipe. Some other site conditions that should have been taken into consideration is the age of this roof. This roof is over 20 years old and it is shedding asphalt considerably. Probably one of the worst ones I've ever seen. And it was pulling all those into this downspout. And then you saw it collecting in the pipe that I removed at the beginning of the video. Another site condition to take into consideration is all the leaves that could potentially end up in the gutter down spouts and the drain lines. So we want to use the best pipe that is going to allow for those debris to be easily pushed through the system. And you know, I use corrugated pipe. However, whenever I make a decision to recommend to the client, I like to take all site conditions and constraints into consideration so that I can give them the information that they need in order for them to make the final decision on which pipe to use. A lot of guys that do drainage get mad at me, you know, for saying don't use corrugated pipe. I'm not saying don't use it. Just don't use it on the wrong site conditions. You know, I get the point of using corrugated pipe for a installation company. It's the profit margins are a lot greater. I mean, it's so easy to install. It comes in a big old giant roll. You dig a trench and flop it down in there, then cover it back up. You don't have to deal with, you know, connecting a bunch of fittings and gluing them or silicone them, whichever one you prefer. So that is what needs to be taken into consideration whenever choosing and selecting the correct pipe for your drainage system. And that should be determined by site conditions or site constraints. If you're going to use corrugated pipe, are you going to be able to achieve that 2% slope that you need in order to push debris through your drainage pipe? So what I chose to do and recommended to the client was is that we use solid PVC pipe and install it to that similar of an indoor plumbing system. And that's what you see in the pictures. I hope that this video has helped to illustrate what all goes into the selection process when it comes to selecting and choosing the correct drainage pipe for your drainage system. This particular site had some pretty odd constraints on it, a little bit different than something that I would normally do. But you know, between the site condition constraints and then the added constraint that the client put on me by not wanting to remove that patio, simply couldn't get under there to dig the lines and bury them below grade. I think perhaps Chuck from Apple Drains would have been the only one that would have been capable of doing that. But I don't know, I think Chuck's busy, so I wouldn't have been able to get him down here to do that for me. But on a more serious note, you've got to take site conditions into consideration. And ultimately, that should be the determining factor as to which pipe to use. If you can't get the correct slope on the pipe for the job site for which you're installing it, then perhaps we need to look at other alternative methods so far as collecting and containing any debris that might get into the system. And this may require the installation of catch basins. As always, thanks for watching. Any questions, any comments, leave them down below. I do leave the comment section open. This is YouTube. That's what it's supposed to be about. Even though I don't like the "you're an idiot" comments so much, but you know, it's all fun and games, I guess, until somebody gets their eye poked out. But if you have any thoughts and something that you can share with the rest of us that will give us some insight, you're welcome to leave your comment. Thanks a lot, guys. We'll see you next time.